Oh, give me a home where the buffaloes roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word and the skies are not cloudy all day. Master Chairperson, honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, and fellow speakers. There was a time when 50 million or more bison roamed the earth. Approximately 30 million were plains bison found in North America alone. A new hide tanning process in Europe during the Industrial Revolution resulted in high demand for cow hides. The cattle population at the time couldn't supply the demand, and Europeans turned their attention to the vast herds of bison in North America. As Europeans trekked west and took out the herds of bison, cattle were imported as food sources at fur trading posts. Eventually, cattle were used as draft power, dairy, meat, and hides as North America was settled. Like bison, cattle are ruminants. They have the ability to convert plants into high-quality protein in the form of milk and meat. Did you know that over 50% of the energy in crops grown for human food cannot be consumed by humans, but it can be consumed by a ruminant? Cattle have been instrumental in grazing marginal grasslands that would not be productive cropland, and they eat crops and crop byproducts that cannot be used as human food. With their ability to graze and consume plants, cattle, like other ruminants, are the original plant-based protein. Owning and raising cattle has always been a decent business. Yes, it has its highs and lows, but lately, the business of beef is greatly under attack. Special interest groups like PETA, Hollywood movie stars, A&W marketing schemes, Memphis Meats, and our own Canada Food Guide. Each one of these groups or businesses has picked an angle to attack beef production. PETA says it's cruel. Hollywood stars say red meat is dirty and cow farts are causing climate change. Memphis Meats wants a world without slaughter and is promoting lab-grown meat. And the fast food industry is using catchphrases to make profits off of you for their hormone and antibiotic-free burgers, as well as their meatless burgers that bleed beet juice. If this wasn't enough for the beef industry, our government has now changed the Canada Food Guide. It now recommends that our human intake of dairy and meat should be cut in half or more, and we should be replacing that protein with plant-based proteins like beans. Now call me crazy, but 7 billion humans consuming beans might have some negative side effects. That's just my opinion, and who cares about that, right? We are in an age of free choice where we have a huge variety of everything at our fingertips, including our food. But with so many choices, do you actually know what you're eating? The Beyond Meat burger has arrived, and Beyond Meat's mission statement is to positively impact human health, the environment, and animal welfare. Does it? Will it? This plant-based protein product might look similar to the real beef burger, but it has already come to light that these food choices are heavily processed. In fact, some research is comparing the list of processed ingredients to those found in dog food, leaving one to question how healthy these products really are. So why are people so obsessed with jumping on the bandwagon of not eating meat? Personally, I think it is because they don't know and understand the pros of eating meat and what the beef industry actually does for the environment. I also feel that companies are vilifying one product over the other to greedily gain market share. It seems people are easily hijacked to believe anything via social media these days. There is a huge amount of misinformation being spread, and humans are literally eating it up. So what can we do? I personally think we need to promote how cattle are positive for the environment and stress the benefits of eating beef. We need to let people know that raising cattle is a good thing and not bad. We need people to know that cattle largely consume grass and forages. In Canada, only 30% of our native grasslands remain, and by grazing cattle on these lands, they keep them healthy and productive. By grazing cattle, where bison once roamed, we are also protecting wildlife habitat and water sources. This is not the case with heavily processed plant-based foods. People also need to know that eating meat is healthy. Did you know that it has been clinically proven that red meat is one of the most important factors for child brain development? And lean beef supplies 14 essential nutrients. It is an excellent source of protein, iron, vitamins, magnesium, phosphorus, and potassium, just to name a few. The Canadian beef industry is really trying to stress that beef belongs, and as beef producers and consumers of beef, we need to do the same. After all, cattle are ruminants, and ruminants are the original plant-based protein. So follow that Canada Food Guide, increase your plant-based protein, and eat beef. Oh, give me a home where the cattle now roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where a steak sizzles on the barbecue and your plant-based protein quota has been reached for the day.